Hey everybody, welcome to Planes Overhead, and we are going to continue with our A320 series, and today we're going to do pressurization system. So before we actually begin, I would like to tell you guys that I am attaching quiz links on every video. You can see the link on the description. So just take that quiz, around about short 10 questions. That will help you assess what you're learning in the course. And this disclaimer remains the same. I do not recommend any practical application of the information that you're learning here. So before we start pressurization, I want you to know these three definitions. So differential pressure is the difference between the pressure outside the aircraft and inside the aircraft. So it's differential pressure. Cabin vertical speed is the rate of climb or descent that the cabin is being maintaining. So what is happening is, if your aircraft is climbing at a certain rate, that's not the same rate the cabin will climb at. So it's a different thing. Cabin altitude is the altitude at which the cabin is being maintained at. So this is also different from your aircraft altitude. For example, if your aircraft is at 35,000 feet, your cabin altitude might be somewhere around 7,000 feet, 8,000 feet. Okay, so it's important to differentiate between the actual aircraft altitude and the cabin altitude and cabin vertical speed as well. Alright, so let's begin pressurization system. So the A320 pressurization system is to adjust cabin altitude and rate of change of cabin altitude. So just keep in mind, the word pressurization is there. The system is actually not pressurizing the aircraft. It is the system that is maintaining cabin altitude or rate of change of cabin altitude. Pressurization is already coming from the air conditioning via the packs. Alright, so it's important to know what this system is doing. So it works in three modes, and the most its mode is that it's running fully automatic. And the three modes are automatic, semi-automatic, manual. So semi-automatic is what is happening is the pilot is setting the landing elevation. Manual, it is under full control of the pilot. As we do the video, you will understand the minute differences. So the components are as follows. It is controlled by two CPCs. Every Airbus system has some computer or a controller. So the pressurization system has cabin pressure controllers. Okay, so there are two of them. One outflow valve with an actuator. It's kind of like a flap that opens at the right side of the aircraft. It is controlled by the CPC via two motors for automatic operation and one motor for manual operation. Now what it does is, it regulates the amount of air allowed to escape the aircraft and is at the right side of the aircraft, as I said. So if the aircraft is being pressurized and the outflow valve will regulate itself and move, it's a valve kind of a flap, and it allows escaping of air. One overhead control panel, which we will talk about. Two safety valves is to avoid excessive differential pressure. So if the aircraft is being pressurized over a excessive value, the safety valves will open and the pressure will be released, so that you don't stress the structure, physical structure of the aircraft. Now what you're looking at is a pressurization flight profile, and we will talk with this. We will be able to understand the automatic operation of the pressurization system. So when in the automatic or semi-automatic mode, either of the CPC alternatively controls the pressurization of the aircraft. So what is happening is, the CPC, there are two CPCs, right? So if on one sector, if CPC 1 is active, while returning on that same sector, your CPC 2 will be active. So it automatically alternatively takes roles. So if one CPC fails, the other one takes over completely, and the indication will be shown on the ECAM. CPC obtains various data from FMGC, LGCIU, EIU, ADIRS. FMGC is Flight Management Guidance System, where it will get its landing elevation information. It's a database, navigational database. Then LGCIU is Landing Gear Control Interface Unit. So it will know the position of the landing gear, whether you're on ground or whether you're in flight. From that, it will retrieve that data. EIU is Engine Interface Unit. So it will know the thrust position of the aircraft, whether it's climb mode, cruising mode, or takeoff thrust, or whatever. ADIRS is Air Data Inertial Reference System. So from this, it obtains our pressure of the outside air, temperatures, and all sort of air data related stuff, with which it will calculate the required pressurization flight profile. So let's begin, and we'll come back to the image as we go through the further slides. So before flight, what's happening? You are parked at the bay, and that time your outflow valve is fully open. There is no pressure differential, so that means whatever is the pressure of the airfield, that will be the same pressure inside the aircraft. And there is no cabin vertical speed, because you're not anyway climbing or descending for that matter. Cabin altitude will be equal to the field elevation, because there is its valve is fully open. The valve is not shut. Alright, so I hope that's clear. Now during takeoff, now there is what interesting thing happens. Pre-pressurization takes place to avoid pressure bump or surge at rotation for passenger comfort. So what is happening is, when you rotate the aircraft, it actually climbs out really fast because it's a jet aircraft anyway, so it's going to climb out really fast. And that can cause trouble to the passengers, because if it climbs out so fast from a normal elevation, it will cause problem. So what Airbus has designed is, suppose example you are at some 2000 feet elevation today, okay? So just before takeoff, when you set your thrust to, you know, toga or your takeoff thrust, it reduces the cabin altitude. Say example 1700. So what that does is it brings passengers down to a lower altitude. And when you actually climb out and the pressurization system kicks in, it will slowly climb the cabin altitude accordingly. So that helps in, you know, giving passenger comfort rather than just climbing out really fast. Outflow valve is slightly closed and it descends the cabin altitude at 400 feet per minute till the differential pressure reaches 0.1 psi. As you can see, minus 400 feet you're descending, descend the aircraft till it reaches a differential pressure of 0.1 psi with respect to the outside conditions. Okay, so we're done with during takeoff. During cruise, the outflow valve is controlled by the CPC according to the flight profile. So it depends on the flight profile, whatever the flight profile is. If you're climbing, it will control accordingly. The CPC will calculate from its data and it will adjust the cabin altitude as required. So, but important point here to note is CPC does not allow a differential pressure to exceed 8.06 psi. So that is perhaps a structural limit that Airbus has designed for this aircraft. So it will not exceed this value here, and it will also not exceed cabin altitude more than 8,000 feet. So that's the max limits, and that is what will be followed. As you can see here, nothing more than 8.06 psi. Now this thing is empty here, so it will adjust accordingly to maintain the profile. Okay, next, during approach or landing. Now approach or landing also, it does a very smart thing. So since approach is loaded in your database FMGC, so it will calculate the top of descent, and that information will be shared to the CPC. The outflow valve is then controlled by the CPC to depressurize the aircraft just before landing. So before you're just coming into land, it will calculate what descent rate to maintain so that you just before, when you're shortly before landing, the aircraft will be depressurized. As you can see here, suppose this is your top of descent here, it will start the cycle here. It is starting to depressurize, okay? And it will maintain just before touchdown, it will be depressurized. This is the aircraft profile. This is the cabin altitude profile. So it's a lot of difference, as you can see. Suppose this is 35,000, this could be somewhere around about 7,000. Okay. So the top of descent is here. So the cabin will also descend accordingly at a slow, very slow depressurization rate. And in case there is some pressure still left, it will be released at 500 feet per minute, 55 seconds after landing. The max cabin altitude vertical speed it will maintain is 750 feet per minute. So why 750 feet per minute? Because anything above that, it will actually cause passenger discomfort. So it is a maximum limitation. It will actually not descend at that rate. It will be further less only. So that is the maximum value. And any residue, suppose in case there's some pressure still left inside the aircraft, it will know. And after 55 seconds of that, it will actually start to just remove that pressure. 500 feet per minute till the difference is 0.1 psi. Okay, so and as you can see, MLG compressed, this is main landing gear, so it is compressed, it knows that it has landed. And once after 55 seconds that is done, the valve will fully open and you'll be in the ground mode again. So this is the automatic way of doing things. Okay, so let's go on to ECAM indications and then we'll come back to the overhead panel. So this is what the pressurization page will look like on the ECAM via the ECP, that's the ECAM control panel. So here your landing elevation is set manually. If it is set automatically, it will show AUTO auto. And this is the elevation that has been set by the pilot. These are the dials, delta PA, delta P, delta differential pressure, that is PSI, the reading. Vertical speed in feet per minute. This is the cabin vertical speed, just keep in mind. This is not the aircraft vertical speed. There's also the cabin altitude. So it's maintaining around about 4,150 feet inside the cabin. Now, what diagram we are interested with is this one at the bottom. Okay. So this is the pressurization systems diagram. So system one indicates CPC one is active. System two indicates your CPC2 is active. Currently, it is in manual mode, so it is showing at the top manual MAN. Okay. Safety valve, though there are two safety valves, but the indication is only one. So if either one safety valve opens, so the this flap will open, either one of them. It doesn't necessarily doesn't mean that if two safety valves open, then only this flap will open. Now, these are the inlet and extract valves. This is important from the avionics ventilation. It's the same system here, and it is for our indication to know what's the position of inlet and extract valves so that we can identify if there's a pressurization leak. PAC 1 and PAC 2, whichever is serving. And this indicator is the important one, the outflow valve indicator. So it has certain markings for us to tune it, fine tune it manually. So with this indicator, you can actually adjust the outflow valve. And already I mentioned the vent on the ECAM panel is the avionics ventilation. Okay, now this is the overhead panel. So what is happening is, in case of we were talking about the three modes, right? Automatic we have completed. Semi-automatic, what it does is, in case the FMGC, the database, doesn't have the landing elevation of that airport today, then you can actually go into the semi-automatic mode. In that, what you have to do is, by default, it is on auto, as you can see here. You can move this knob to set the landing elevation of the airfield. Another important thing to know is, these are in thousands. So this is -2000, this is 0, this is 2000, this is 4000. So these values are in thousands, okay? And you can set this and check it on the ECAM panel, ECAM page, where whatever have you set. So in case semi-automatic mode, landing elevation non can be set to destination elevation. In case of manual mode, when your both CPCs have failed, okay? Generally, by default, it is in auto. But if it has failed, the fault light will come in amber. You go in the manual mode by pressing manual switch. Mode selector is set to manual. Then what happens is this switch gets activated, this toggle switch, manual vertical speed control. So this is a toggle switch that will control the outflow valve. So if you move it up, the toggle, the outflow valve goes up, it opens up. If you move it down, the outflow valve shuts. So according to the requirement, when you're manual control, when you're under manual control, you can use that toggle switch to adjust the outflow valve and then change your pressurization of the cabin. The last switch here is, you can see, is ditching. So ditching switch is a guarded flap switch. So it is in case of an emergency where you have to ditch the aircraft. So you lift this and press on. Now what this does is, important thing, it shuts all the valves below flotation line. Okay, so those valves are outflow valve, ram air valve, and vents of the avionics ventilation, pack flow valves, etc. So those valves will be shut completely so that water doesn't actually seep into the aircraft, and hence you'll get more little time to float. All right, I think that's all we are done with this pressurization system. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching, guys. Subscribe to the YouTube channel and like the Facebook page for regular updates. Give the video a thumbs up if you like the video. Do not forget to share it too. Comment below if you have any doubts. I'll get back to you as soon as possible. And I'll see you in the next video, guys. Cheers and happy landings. Have a great day. Bye-bye.